Hi everyone, I'm Mackenzie with the Beaverton City Library at Murray Shoals normally, but today I'm at home and I'm going to give you a STEM challenge activity that you can do at home with supplies that you probably have at home. So just a reminder, STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. And today's activity, as well as the extensions, will involve all of those things, including an art component, in this case, a writing component. All right, so today's STEM challenge is called Gotcha! Create a model of a frog's tongue that can catch a fly. There will be no real frogs or flies in this challenge, just some crafting supplies that we have at home. So the supplies that you will need include craft sticks or popsicle sticks, and tape of some sort. It says green paper plates. I don't have green paper plates. I just grabbed a regular white one and I just colored it green. Also, you will need some flies. I just ripped up some scrap paper to make some irregularly shaped and sized flies. You'll need some straws and some strips of red paper. And you'll see later that you'll want these cut to different sizes. All right, so now is about a great time to go gather your supplies. And if you're back, start thinking about how you're going to use these supplies to design your frog and its mouth and the tongue and how you're going to combine everything and cut everything so that it meets the challenge. Now, if you need a hint, I have one for you. It says, use the straw to roll and unroll the paper tongue. All right, so this is when you'll design. You might sketch it out first. You might just start cutting and taping things together, whatever works best for you, all right? If you're asking what's going on, I have some answers for you. Frogs' tongues are attached actually to the front of their mouths, not at the back like humans. A frog's tongue is also 10 times softer than a human tongue, which makes their tongues like shock absorbers. The frog's saliva also helps to make the tongue super sticky. When a frog catches an insect, it throws its sticky tongue out of its mouth and wraps it around its prey. The frog's tongue then snaps back and throws the food down its throat. Very descriptive. Okay, as promised, I have some extension activities for you based on this challenge. The first one is science-based, and it says, what do you know about frogs? Research how frogs catch their prey. How can this help you with your design? You can search online if you go to the beavertonlibrary.org under kids and then homework help and then scroll to the bottom to databases. It will take you to the WCCLS website, and the kids info bits is a great one to look up some information about frogs. Next is technology. Is there another material that is not listed that we didn't use that you would like to use? Take a look around your home, see what you can find, what your grown-up says you can use. What is that material and how would it make your design better? Engineering. How can you make your frog catch more than one fly? Change your design and try it. Art. Write a story about a frog who cannot catch a fly. How does this frog overcome their problem? And last but not least, math. This is where your tape measure will come in handy. Measure the length of your frog's tongue when it's unrolled. Can making it longer or shorter help with your design? So that is this week's challenge. Gotcha. Hope that you have fun exploring the different sort of extension activities, and thank you so much for joining us. See you next time.